Originally, I had intended to make a few OBS tutorials as a way to get back into YouTube, but after writing and voicing the first video, I realized it did not really offer anything unique, just a different version of what other content creators had already done. So I started over, and instead decided to make a series of videos showing you how to use OBS in unusual ways. I plan to show methods that are hardly ever mentioned in a sea of tutorials. Hopefully somebody out there will find them helpful. If you use OBS for streaming, chances are you process your microphone audio in some way to get it ready for broadcast. If that involves using the audio chain built into OBS and would like to share that filtered audio with other apps like Discord, the technique I'm going to show you today might be for you. First, a little background into why I or anybody would want to do something like this. Well, I live in South Texas, where the average weather pretty much requires me to have a fan running nearby to keep myself cool and comfortable. Unfortunately, even running on its quietest setting, it could still be picked up by my old condenser microphone. After some research, I decided to try a dynamic microphone to leverage their inherent noise rejection, namely the SE Electronics V7X. With some extra tweaks in OBS, I think the audio quality I achieved with this new mic is quite good, even with a fan nearby. However, I soon discovered one flaw with using an unprocessed dynamic mic in Discord. The audio level was much lower than Discord was expecting. This issue led me to create this unusual way to use OBS. The key to being able to get a feed of your microphone from OBS is a loopback audio device. Most know these by the popular brands VB cable or virtual audio cable. No matter what the brand, the effect is the same. They take audio being sent to the output device and bring it back into the input device. Think of it like connecting an aux cable between the speaker out to the line in. In my setup, I use an Audient Evo 4 to not only capture audio from my mic, but also provide the virtual loopback audio device. Before experimenting with this technique, I highly suggest watching through the entire video first, just to make sure you have all the information. Here's how to get it set up. In OBS, click Settings, Audio. Under the Advanced section, change your monitoring device to be your loopback device. In my case, Loopback 1-2 Audient Evo 4. Your specific loopback device may be named something different. Once you find it and have it selected, click OK. Right-click on any of your audio channels in OBS and select Advanced Audio Properties. Change the audio monitoring of your mic to Monitor and Output. Open your Discord user settings. Under Voice and Video, set your input device to be the other side of your loopback device. You can also adjust your Discord audio settings to remove some of Discord's audio processing so you can be in control of your mic quality. I suggest turning off automatic input sensitivity and setting the level down to -80 dB, especially if you have noise cancellation and gating set up in OBS.
So just a couple extra things here in post, because for some reason I forgot to voice over this section of the script. If you scroll down, there are a few other settings that you're going to want to change. You're going to want to turn off noise suppression. You're also going to want to turn off echo cancellation, noise reduction, automatic gain control, and make sure that your attenuation settings are all turned off as well. This is going to allow you to send the best quality audio over Discord without Discord messing with the signal that you're sending from OBS.
At this point, Discord should now have a feed of your post-process mic, and anyone in Discord can hear you exactly as your stream viewers would. That is really all there is to it. You can press the Let's Check button in Discord to give it a try. And here's a little extra tip. For apps that don't support changing the audio input device and instead rely on Windows to select one, you can force specific apps to use specific audio devices in the App Volume and Device Preferences page of the new Windows Control Panel. From here, you can set the input device to any currently running app. This also comes in handy when you want to set up OBS to record audio sources independently to be mixed later. If this technique is not working, here are some things to check. Does your audio interface have a software mixer for the loopback mix? In the case of the Audient Evo 4, there is a software mixer which allows for adjusting what is included in the loopback. For our purposes, we only need the loopback output going into the loopback input. All the other sources can be removed. Does your audio device even support loopback? Some audio interfaces don't support loopback at all, so an alternative method is to use VB cable. Once you install VB cable, it creates two audio devices. One is an input and one is an output. Again, everything sent to the output will be brought back into the input. So what are some of the downsides to this technique? Well, to start, you have to have OBS running all the time. You don't need to be streaming or recording, but since you're using the filters in the mic audio chain, OBS needs to be running to generate the audio feed going into the loopback. Another downside is if you mute your mic in OBS, you will also mute yourself in Discord. This might cause an issue for those who like to use stream starting soon slides. There is a workaround which involves creating a duplicate audio capture within your holding slide scene and adjusting the audio monitoring to monitor only. It is a bit disconcerting since there's no real on-screen indication that your mic is indeed not going out on stream and only being used locally, but the workaround is functional. I highly suggest testing it out before going live with it. Remember, what works for one person might not work for everybody, but personally, I find the audio quality I was able to achieve with this setup to be a massive improvement from my old setup. If you found this video informative or helpful, please consider leaving a like. If you thought it was stupid and unnecessary, please feel free to let me know in the comments. I plan to do future videos about odd uses for OBS, so subscribe if you'd like to see more. Thanks for watching.